Hello everyone, my name is Poonam and I'm currently living in South Korea for over 8 months. I was born in India, but I grew up in Italy and I spent all my life over there and while I was graduating from university. And at the time I wanted to explore more and I wanted to travel somewhere where I could work and study. So at the time I was really wanting to leave Italy and go somewhere else and be more independent. And the first thing that came in my mind was South Korea. So far, life in Korea has been amazing. I had a lot of good experience and people have been always kind and nice to me. The only thing that, of course, I miss is my family and my friends, and sometimes there is the language barrier, so sometimes it's hard to communicate, but that slowly I'm studying Korean, so everything will be fine after I get used to it. So after I came to Korea, I had a couple of months before starting my Korean lesson. So I was getting really bored. So I decided to start a YouTube channel as a pastime, as a hobby. So I started making these videos about my lifestyle in Korea, how an Indian person lives in Korea, because there are so many other American foreigners making YouTube channel in Korea, but there are not many Indians. So I thought that I could be one of them. And while I started doing the YouTube channel, I started showing the Korean lifestyle from an Indian point of view. And after a while, so many Indian people, especially Indian girls, started asking me about Korean language, because in India, girls don't have much opportunity to study Korean because there are not many schools and it's too expensive. So I decided to make also Korean lessons through my YouTube channel and teach them what I was learning at the university. So every university in South Korea has different requirements. So what was applied for me is not necessary, it will be the same in other universities. So as for my university, I go to the Cheonnam-dae University, which is in Gwangju. So when I was applying for the university, I was requested my diploma. So it can be your high school degree or your university degree. And it depends from which country you are coming. So if you are Indian, you have to get an apostille, which is basically a stamp on your diploma paper, which makes your diploma legal in every part of the world. So you have to get that stamp before coming to Korea. So that is very important. Number two is that before applying to the university, you have to make a bank statement, which usually it's for 2 semesters, so it's 6 months. Usually it's $10,000. So you have to prove that you have $10,000 under your name in your bank account, which is like a security money, which means that you can survive in Korea with that money. And number three is that you have to get a medical report. So you have to prove that you don't have any illness, or even though if you have it, you have to prove it as a security, as a safety. So those three are very important, and I think it's requested in any kind of university. And then the fee, the dorm, the application paper fee, I think is different in every university. So you have to go to the website of the university you want to apply, and you can find all the information. Everything is written on the website. So I don't think there is something that Indians can do or cannot do. There's not jobs that they can only do Indians, or other jobs that they cannot do. So every jobs are available. The only thing is that if your Korean is really good, you can get a really good job. If your Korean is not good, you can do a part-time job at bars, cafe, or even Indian restaurants. Or you can, if you're good at Korean or English, you can teach English, for example, as a private part-time job. Indians are really good at maths and engineering, So I see so many Indians coming from India to Korea, especially Seoul, and they study engineering over here, so they can get easily jobs at software engineering company or also big companies that are also present in India, for example Samsung or stuff like that. So they can be easily part of these two businesses, they can be like an entrepreneur between India and Korea. And another thing is that nowadays there is so much, India is growing economically, is getting bigger day by day, and there are so many investments in Korean businesses, so they can be part of that business as well. Koreans are very different from Indians and Italians, especially the way they approach people, because I got used to live in Italy where people are easily to approach. And here I think that the Korean society, they are very busy and they really oriented in work. So they are also so busy, so it's hard to approach them easily. So at first when I came here, I found them kind of hard to approach. But day by day I understand that it's the society. It's because they are so busy in their work life and in their personal life, so it's hard to have time to talk to them. But as I was living here, I get to know more about the society and more about the people and everyone. Every time I need something or I was asking for help, everyone was really always ready to help me, ready to give me a hand. So they've been really kind to me. And I've always got, so far I've had a good positive experience, and I'm really glad about it because I hear so many bad comments about other people having bad experience or people that come from other countries and they are treated differently. But thankfully that didn't happen to me, and it could be because I live in Gwangju and here the foreigner population is lower than the other cities, so probably that's why people are more open, are more kinder. And so far I have a good experience, and they always get they always wonder about me. They get always curious when they see me, because it's not common to see Indian people, especially in this area. So they always ask me about where I'm from and about my nose piercing, for example, because it's really like a rare thing here. So far, so good. So I've been seeing that so many Indians are getting interested in Korean culture, and that is because of K-pop and K-drama. And if you want to come to Korea because you are wondering about the lifestyle, it's the same in K-pop or K-drama, you can come here for traveling, for visiting. But if you want to come here and want to work here, have a future here, then you have to do your research at home. So nowadays Indian people are getting interested a lot about the Korean culture, especially thanks to K-pop and K-drama. So if your plan is to coming to Korea because you're interested in K-drama, K-beauty, you can come here for traveling. But if you want to come here as a working to make a future and have a career here, things are very much different from what is shown in K-drama or in K-pop. So life is good here. But if you are planning to stay here for a longer time, then it's very important to take step by step and think carefully about that decision.